Last but not least is my very own youngest son, John Patrick Nimmers. John, you know what to do, right? Yeah, I'll take that. There you go.
Hey, I'm John. As you can probably tell, I was raised in a Christian family, loving family. Got raised with the Bible. They taught me all about it and everything. But I grew up as a kid and all throughout like elementary and middle school and everything. And I mean, before I got saved, I really didn't have a conscience. Like, that's the only way I know how to explain it. I really didn't. Like, when I hit high school, that's when everything went downhill for me. My whole life revolved around drugs, doing drugs, selling drugs, you know, anything. The party life, drinking. I mean, when you live that life, it's going to come back and slap you in the face, as I learned out pretty quick. I went to jail at the age of 16, sent some kid to the hospital. I mean, but you think that when all that stuff happens to you, that it's going to, like, you know, slap in the face, like, hey, wake up, you know. You need to get your life together. It didn't. I just kept on doing whatever I wanted. You know, it didn't really matter to me. But one day, me and my buddy went to a party that we shouldn't have gone to. But and we got jumped, and I got my shoulder dislocated. And then the next morning, my brother Daniel went and came and picked me up from to take me to the doctor to get myself checked out. And you know, I just walked out there, you know, expecting, hey, how are you doing? I see your shoulder's dislocated. You know, he just looked at me and he's just like, John, you know, what are you doing with your life? Like, what are you doing? That just hit me like a ton of bricks right there. Because, I mean, he's my best friend. He's that guy that's always there for me no matter what. And he got so sick of the way that I was living that he didn't even want. Like, I don't know, it just hit me hard right there. So after that happened, I started to get interested. I wanted to actually learn about what having a relationship with Jesus Christ meant. And if you guys knew me through high school, as I see some of my buddies over here, learning wasn't exactly on my to-do list. So, I mean, that's something changed right there already. But, and so I started reading, actually wanting to come to church and wanting to learn about God. And my heart, I could already tell, my heart was getting a little changed right there. And I heard about Lake Ann. I didn't even know this little guy went to Lake Ann, so that's pretty cool. Rock on, Lake Ann. But and so I went there with wanting to change. I went there for one reason, to hear Ken Rudolph speak, because I heard he was a really good communicator. And I was right, he is a really good communicator. So I listened to him. And in that week at Lake Ann, my life changed and God saved me. My heart changed. He came in my life and completely changed it. So, I mean, I've said this before, like, I've heard the expression, a walk with Jesus Christ, and I never really understood it. I just heard it a lot. I heard people say it a lot. But, I mean, you know what it means when you actually get saved, because you're literally walking with Christ. You're literally step by step growing with him in a relationship every single day. And it's just the greatest thing you can ever feel. Because, I mean, like I said before in the beginning of my testimony, that I didn't have a conscience. When I got saved, I had a conscience. I got something, someone, the Holy Spirit, telling me, yeah, no, you can't do this. Like, that's not right. You can't do this. And, like, I don't know, it's different, it's great, I love it, but, you know, it's just, it's amazing, and God's doing some great things in my life, and I'm excited, so.
Amen. Well, John, I don't know what to say, I'm just thankful. Thankful to God for many prayers behind the scenes going up for you, for your soul. Many people in this church crying out to God on your behalf for those years, those dark, dark years, And I think you put it best. You did have a conscience, but it was completely hardened. You weren't listening to anything. And that was evident to us as well. And but how grateful we are that God cut through. And the scripture says that he is able to save to the uttermost those who come to him by faith. And like me, you're a part of that uttermost. We're all a part of it, but some people like us, we've been down in the gutter to understand what it means to utter. Anyway. Terrible rhyme. Terrible rhyme. But it does make sense. We were in the gutter, and Jesus reached into our life, didn't he?
Yep.
So I thank God that you're part of the uttermost. And I pray that this resurrection power that you spoke of at the men's day and corn feed here last week, and I might add very eloquently about the power of Jesus' resurrection to raise, I mean, the very fact that God could raise up his son from the dead, I think is how you put it. It's not a problem for him changing your life, raising you up. And that is exactly what we're seeing happening in your life. We're grateful to God for that. We're humbled and we're grateful and pray that God will just greatly use you in the days to come for his glory. Amen. Let's pray for John. Father, thank you so much for John. We thank you for bringing him out of darkness into your glorious light. And there's no other way of putting it, Lord. While all of us could say we've been in the dark and we've come into the light, those of us who know Jesus, some of us, Lord, understand that darkness maybe a little better than others. And we thank you, Lord, for the truth of your word where Jesus said he is the one who will save us to the uttermost if we come to him by faith. And I thank you that you've done that for John. I pray, Lord, that the Spirit of God he referred to would fill his life, keep his conscience keen and sharp and sensitive to you, and that you too would you'd raise him too up as a champion for Jesus. We ask all these things in his name. Amen. John, it's a great joy as your dad to be able to, upon your profession of faith in Christ, baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.